गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, द टॉपिक फॉर माई टूडेज प्रेजेंटेशन इज बायोटेक्नोलॉजी एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशन. दिस इज द फोर्थ यूनिट. अंडर दिस टॉपिक वी विल कवर द डेफिनेशन ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशन इन द फील्ड ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर. सो वट इज बायोटेक्नोलॉजी? लेट्स स्टार्ट विद अ सिंपल एग्जाम्पल. द मेकिंग ऑफ कर्ड, CURD, कर्ड from milk with the help of microbes at our homes. This is a microbe mediated process and it is useful for human beings because curd is good for health. So we can say biotechnology is the process of making a product that is good for human being with the help of organisms. These organisms can be microbes, fungus, plants and animals also, or some part of the cell of these organisms also. So the technique used to make something good from these microorganisms is known as the biotechnology. Now coming to the formal definition of biotechnology, biotechnology deals with techniques of using live organisms or enzymes from organisms to produce products and processes useful to human. So making of curd, making of bread, making of wine, they are the biotechnological processes. Even the techniques like test tube baby production with the help of in vitro fertilization, making of vaccines and gene therapy, these all are the processes or techniques of the biotechnology. So biotechnology is useful as a therapy in the therapeutic diagnostics, genetically modified crops for agriculture, processed food, bioremediation, waste treatment and energy production. But we will today discuss only the application of biotechnology in agriculture. As we all know that population is increasing day by day, and to feed this huge population we have to increase the food production. To increase the food production there are three opinions. The agriculture is of three types. Number one, agrochemical based agriculture, organic agriculture or genetically engineered crop based agriculture. In first, agrochemical based agriculture, there is the use of fertilizers and pesticides for the high production or for the high yield. On this, green revolution was based. And the other one is the organic agriculture, that is by the use of natural products that is useful for the environment as well as for the human health. And third one, genetically engineered, means the organisms, plants should be modified so that they can give high yield or high production of food. So green revolution, the father of green revolution is Dr. M.S. Swaminathan ji. Crop production increased by using improved crop varieties, that is known as the high yielding varieties. And there was the better crop management practices and the use of agrochemicals, that is fertilizer and the pesticides. In the green revolution, food supply was tripled, but was not enough still for the growing population. So agrochemicals are also expensive, that cannot be afforded by the farmers. And even the existing varieties that can increase the yield is not possible with the conventional breeding methods. So there should be some changes in the conventional methods of breeding for the production of high yield for the huge number of population. So there is a question, is there a way to minimize the use of fertilizers and chemicals so that their harmful effects on the environment are reduced? So answer to this question is yes, genetically modified crops. जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड क्रॉप्स कैन बी प्रिपेयर्ड बाय जेनेटिकली मॉडिफाइड ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट इज GMO. Why we need to produce the genetically modified crops? Because genetically modified plants is useful in many ways. Number one, they have more nutritional value of food. For example, vitamin A enriched rice, also known as the golden rice. They have better nitrogen fixation capacity. They can tolerate to abiotic stress like high cold, drought conditions, high salt condition, low salt condition, high heat, low heat. They can tolerate. And even the genetically modified crops, they can reduce reliance on the chemical pesticides. So because they are the pest resistant crops, we will discuss in the next slides how we can prepare the pest resistant crops. Then to reduce post-harvest loss, and then increase the efficiency of mineral uses by the plants. So with this capacity, we can maintain the fertility of the soil, and then is the production of disease-resistant crops from the other causative agents or microorganisms. Pest-resistant plants. The pest, for example, grasshopper, caterpillar, beetle, bugs, thrips, worms, they can spoil the crops. For this, we have to apply insecticides and pesticides. So, how to make the plants resistant to pest so that we can minimize the use of pesticides? By the introduction of BT toxin to the target plant. What is BT toxin? BT toxin is produced by a bacteria. The name of that bacteria is Bacillus thuringiensis, and this toxin is produced by the BT toxin gene that is present in this bacteria. So BT toxin gene is cloned from the bacteria and it is expressed in the plants to provide resistance to insects, so that we should minimize the use of the insecticides and the pesticides. Till now, BT cotton, BT corn, BT rice, BT tomato, potato and soybean have been prepared with the help of BT toxin resistant crops. Now the mechanism of BT toxin. Once this is inserted into the plant and plant become pest resistant, then how it act on the pest? The bacteria Bacillus thuringiensis produce protein that kill certain insects such as Lepidopterans, that is tobacco woodworm, and armyworm, and Coleopterans, beetles, and Diapterans, flies and mosquitoes. Bacillus thuringiensis form protein crystals during a particular phase of their growth. These crystals contain a toxic insecticidal protein, and these proteins or toxin exist in an inactive form, and the inactive form of the BT toxin protein is protoxins. And when this protoxin once enter into the insect after its biting, and it is converted into active form, and due to activation is due to the alkaline pH of the midgut of the insects, and due to activation of this protein or BT toxin protein,
It is solubilized and solubilize the crystals. The crystals in the solubilized form bind to the surface of the midgut epithelial cells, and after its binding, it create pores in the epithelial cells, and after it is then the cell gets swelled or it got swollen, and after swollen it is lysed. So thus it caused the death of the insect. So the genes that encode for the Bt toxin are known as the CRY cryogens, and different types of cryogens are Cry1AC and Cry2AB. They are cotton ball bombs, and Cry1AB is the corn borers. In this slide, you can see how to prepare the pest resistant plants. So first, the gene that is present in the bacteria, suppose that bacteria is Bacillus thuringiensis, and that bacteria contain the DNA. So the on my left hand side, the bacterial structures from bacteria, we have isolated the DNA. After isolation of the DNA, DNA is a very long string. We are not interested in the whole DNA. We are interested in a small segment of DNA. That small segment of DNA is known as the gene, and that gene will code a protein that will kill the pest. So we taken some segment of that DNA, that is gene, and the gene is cloned. Clone means we have to make multiple copies of that gene. After making multiple copies, the process is known as the transformation with the help of bacteria. Then it is transferred to the plant to whom we want to make the pest resistance. That means that gene we have to introduce into the plant to whom we want to make a pest resistant. This we will do with the help of a biotechnological technique that is known as the plant tissue culturing. What is plant tissue culturing? The detail we will discuss in the next presentations. Once this gene is introduced into a plant, then we will do, then we will prepare multiple copies of that plant, and that with the help of plant breeding, and then that plant's species or that plant which is now pest resistant is in the nurseries for the further propagation and the land level or in the fields, trials in the field. In this slide, you can see how these Bt plants or pest resistant plants act on the pests. In my left hand side, there are Bt genes that we transferred from the bacteria, that is Bacillus thuringiensis, into a corn plant. From corn plant, now when this corn plant is pest resistant, what will happen? If any pest will come, like this European corn borer will come and feed on the plant, corn plant, if they will ingest the protein encoded by the Bt genes, what will happen? That will perforate the epithelial lining or midgut of that insect. You can see the Bt protein penetrate and collapse the cells lining the gut, and the insect dies. So students, there is question for you. Why is the toxin produced by Bacillus thuringiensis toxic to other insects but not to itself? There are four options. Number one, Bt has an enzyme that cleaves the toxin. And number two, the toxin is enclosed in a capsule. And third one is the toxin is inactive in Bt, or the Bt is resistant to the toxin. Please choose right option and send in the comment box. So students, today we have learned about the biotechnology and its role in agriculture, especially to prepare the pest resistant plants. If any query, please mail me at foolarani@